So, Kate, you have been investing in CTV for a while. Tell us a little bit about the background of how Pinnacle began investing in OTT, why it is, and sort of the opportunities it presents now.
Yeah, absolutely. So we are constantly searching for and evaluating the next new big thing. We were fortunate enough to get in on the OTT space early about 6 years ago with the implementation of Hulu. Since then, it has obviously become a much larger space in terms of the different inventory and partners that you can possibly work with, from going direct to being able to buy programmatically. It's just exploded. So that's awesome from an advertiser's perspective because it gives us another place where we can effectively and efficiently target our consumer on an impression-based media. So it's a nice extension of our television buys, and that's kind of how it started. It was a way for us to complement our linear television and cable schedules, but in a way that we could target that one-to-one impression level to hit our consumers. So the nice thing about that in terms of OTT versus linear is that we don't have that guessing game or that waste because we know that those are verified impressions that ran, and it doesn't necessarily matter what programming that you're running in too. So I think every agency has kind of come up with their own definitions of what that space looks like. I know a lot of the terminology gets thrown around in terms of OTT, CTV, and anything in between, VOD. Every company that we work with has a little bit of a different way of portraying that. For us, it's really about the content. So it doesn't necessarily matter anymore if your audience is watching a program that you might not have ordinarily targeted with your linear buy because you know that they're watching. So I think that's really one of the biggest differences. It's allowed us to extend our linear reach. To have that, more drilled down, targeted approach to long form video.
So, Kate, I wanted to ask you about the consistency of measurement because, and what kind of challenge that presents to you. When you talk about OTT, there's so many platforms and so many devices. What's important for you in terms of consistency in measurement?
I think that to your point, there is a lot of measurement. We have, ACR is one of the newer technologies where we can passively read what's on someone's screen. There are different limitations to that, but we can also track impressions via ad servers to ensure that those impressions are truly being delivered to our target consumer. And then I think the nice thing, at least within the OTT space, is because it is impression based and we know what ran and when it ran and how it may have impacted or driven our potential results, we can take more immediate actions rather than in the linear space. It's a little bit more difficult in terms of determining attribution or being able to take actionable steps, I guess, after your schedule runs because that information has that slight delay in terms of reporting.
What about attribution? Where would you like to see attribution tools go? Meaning for CTV or OTT?
For OTT, I think right now it's very fragmented. So we've, just over the past several months spoken to probably a dozen different attribution partners. We have our own model and forecasting that we use internally, but I think it's really just figuring out what we're most comfortable with in terms of being able to determine what our KPIs are. So the difficult thing with OTT is that it's not a clickable environment. So really a lot of the KPIs for OTT in terms of our delivery would be video completion rate. Well, video completion rate, then we need to understand how that translates into a conversion. And that's the more difficult piece of it in terms of being able to pixel our sites and look at our view-through conversions and really figure out what are we trying to get the consumer to do? Or is this really just being used as more of a broad media to get our message out there and stay top of mind when a consumer is in the consideration set. They might not be ready to convert right now too. So I think that's part of the overall strategy.
And I wanted to ask, Kate, how you see how events in 2020 have accelerated the evolution of media measurement, some trends in advertising, content distribution, and why a more audience-centric approach is necessary for buying and selling. We hear a lot about audience-centric. Consumers are in control to a great degree. Give us your thoughts on some of those trends that we're seeing.
Yeah, so I think every year it gets more and more complex in terms of all of the different avenues in which we can target our audience. 2020 was absolutely no exception. And at the same time, while we need to make sure that we are using those audience-based mediums, I think 2020 really also showed that linear television isn't dead, right? A lot of people kind of focused in on, wow, I can buy digitally and I can hit my audience and I can use targeting. Well, now there's a big portion of that audience that would be in the consideration set that you're missing. So we're just seeing consumption up across the board. Now that everybody is home, you know, from television, we're seeing daytime ratings are increasing because people are home, they have the news on, but also just video in general, people on their phones. So again, it's just created a more complex space. And that's really where it's important for the, before you go into market to determine your tactics, really understanding who your consumer is, because that's going to be different depending on the vertical, the market, and exactly who your audience is. It could be completely different tactics that you would select. It's not a one size fits all solution. So that's something that's really, really important. We can't be effective in terms of how we're buying without having a really, really effective strategy behind that.
And finally, some of your thoughts about the success of Pinnacle, how you guys differentiate yourself, being independent. You have some really cool clients. Tell us how things are going and how the agency differentiates itself.
Yeah, absolutely. So we are, you know, I would say that one of the things that makes us unique is that you get the quality and the experience of working with a larger agency, but at a much smaller scale. And part of that is why we were able to jump into the OTT space so soon. So we have more opportunity and less layers to kind of get through to be able to test out some of these really unique opportunities, which allows our clients to be ahead of the curve. So I think that, you know, our size is actually a really great benefit, and we've seen tremendous growth, not only with, you know, new clients, but also helping to grow our existing clients. And if our clients don't succeed, then we don't succeed. And our team really takes that personally, and we do everything in our power to, you know, really vet out every opportunity that could possibly exist. And we enjoy that. So I think we just have a really, really incredible group. From the creative team to the account team to our media team. It's really just a big family, and everybody works together and we succeed together. And I think that our hard work helps to make our clients more successful, which thus makes us more successful and just a better agency in general. So I'm incredibly proud and grateful to be working for a company that allows these sorts of opportunities.